It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Damn, who knew? All the planes we flew, good things we've been through, that I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place.
Can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began.
Oh,
I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
You both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong and what's small turn to a friendship turn to a bond and that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost. When brotherhood come first and the line will never be crossed, established it on our own when that line had to be drawn and that line is what we reach, so remember me when I'm gone.
Can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
So let the light guide your way. Yeah. Hold every memory as you go. And every road you take will always lead you. It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Straight. My friends are in the bathroom getting higher than the Empire State. My lover, she's waiting for me just across the bar. My seat's been taken by some sunglasses asking about a scar. And I know I gave it to you months ago. I know you're trying to forget. But between the drinks and subtle things, the holes in my apologies, you know, I'm trying hard to take it back. So if by the time the bar closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight. We are young, so let's set the world on fire. We can burn brighter than the sun tonight. So I set the the bar closes and you feel like falling down. I'll carry you home tonight.
Give me your sweater, put it here. Now it's fine, obviously.
If we put them in there, we might remember them.
Live stream's rolling.
Great job. Thanks.
Can we check our water bottles now?
You don't have to now. When they get to ready for the...
No, I know, but just can you check to see if it's behind
or... 7 o'clock.
That way we know that we're not working.
Thank you.
Good evening. Good evening and welcome to the second annual Eastmark High School graduation ceremony. Please rise for the processional performed by our Eastmark High School band and orchestra and remain standing for the presentation and posting of the colors by the Eastmark High School Junior ROTC and the national anthem performed by the Eastmark Coppertones.
Thank you.
dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
You may be seated. To start off our evening, please welcome our district superintendent, Dr. Perry Berry.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Members of the faculty, school board, community members, and graduating seniors. This is graduation week throughout our country. In big cities like Phoenix, Arizona, and small communities alike, people come together to pay tribute to their beloved seniors. And as the superintendent of schools, I am honored to recognize some important people that play supportive roles for our students and also leave our graduates with a few thoughts. I want to start by recognizing our five elected governing board members: Vice President Samantha Davis, board members Patty Campbell, board members James Knox, board member Matt Riffey, and not in attendance is President Jennifer Revolt. These are elected citizens who volunteer their time to serve our students, our staff, and our community. And you probably know this, but our district is the fastest growing district by far in the entire state of Arizona. They have tremendous challenges in front of them, and I really respect the work that they do, and they give us guidance, they hold us accountable, they let us do our job, but they keep the students at the center of every decision. So let's give our board a round of applause. Next, I want to recognize what I call our senior level cabinet members. These are the people that I work closest with in the central office, and among many things, they keep us, our district, in compliance, and basically they give all of our schools and our departments the support and the resources they need to be successful. And I want to start by recognizing our Chief Operating Officer, Amber Stewart, Assistant Superintendent Erica Copeland, Assistant Superintendent Casey Eagleberger, Chief Financial Officer Jennifer Johnson, and Chief Human Resources Officer, Dr. Patty Rogers. Last but not least, I want to thank everyone, all of the administrators, all the faculty, certified, classified staff, who have educated, inspired, and motivated our young people. They've encouraged our students to reach their potential, and I just want to give them a huge shout out, starting with Principal Dr. Tom Swaniger, Assistant Principals Crystal Keller, Assistant Principal Craig Luchner, and Assistant Principal Jesse Roth. Thank you guys for all that you do. I don't know if you know this, but being a high school administrator is not for the faint of heart. They have one of the most challenging, difficult jobs in the country, but it's also one of the most rewarding jobs. So thank you guys for all that you do. Now to end my talk, I want to talk to our senior students. This is certainly a moment where we want to celebrate your success, and that's why we're all here. But we also want to challenge you to pay tribute and to recognize all of the people who have been a part of your success over the years. And I want to take a moment together to recognize the group of people that have helped you be successful, starting with your parents and your family members and your guardians. Let's give them a round of applause. Our families are the first educators. The support that they give you is unbelievable. They hold you accountable, they encourage you, they provide unconditional love, and they're always in your corner. And so I just, on behalf of our governing board and our cabinet, we really appreciate the families. This is a partnership in educating the young people. So thank you guys. Next, I want to recognize what I call our Queen Creek family members. And by that, I mean our certified staff, our administration, our classified staff, all of the elementary teachers that were a part of your education coming up through the ranks. But these are the people, in my opinion, that have chosen worthwhile and noble careers. They want to make a difference. They do not count their reward in the form of dollars and cents. And I just want to take a moment to recognize and thank all of our educators throughout Eastmark High School. And then third and finally, I'd like for all of the senior graduates to please stand for just a moment. Please stand, guys. I've talked about your home families, your Queen Creek families, but you guys have done a great job in taking advantage of the support. You've taken advantage of these opportunities, and for that you should be congratulated. You guys have excelled. I just want to recognize you and say on behalf of our governing board and our cabinet, congratulations, good luck, and God bless you all. And next I would like to pass the mic off to, Luke Crowther, who's the senior class president.
You could be seated if you have yet to.
Okay.
Okay, guys, buckle up. Put on your safety straps. No, really, put them on. You're going to need them. Teachers, please check to make sure your row safety straps are secure. Ready? Too bad. And away we go. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's our freshman year. We're at the peak of our junior high climb, and we're looking down at our drop into high school. Our adrenaline is rushing through our veins. We're at a brand spanking new school with TVs on every wall, football games to watch, and dances to attend. We get to be on high school sports teams, in marching band, take new electives, and most importantly, not being an annoying junior high kid anymore. At the peak of the drop, the roller coaster comes to a screeching halt. The automated message announces the ride has temporarily stopped due to unexpected bugs in the system. Cough, cough, COVID. Everything we were looking forward to is now masked by chaos, and we are left to just sit and wait. Just as we are comfortable being sassy, bougie, and ratchet, the announcer tells us to hold on. The ride is about to begin again. And away we go, but this time it's different. Will sports even happen? Will we be able to have a homecoming dance or have anywhere to go when we get our license and are finally free? We are getting whiplash from all the unexpected bumps and turns that keep coming our way. Our classes are hours long, and the shiny new tables with whiteboard dividers that once were used to keep us from cheating are now being used to keep us 6 feet apart. But we were along for the ride, and we were determined to make it a great year, no matter what. The second half is a quick loop filled with our first ever high school dance, Mr. Firebird, and the first last day at Eastmark. We get to be a part of it all. We take one last turn and speed right into a dark tunnel, also known as our junior year. All of a sudden, it was like COVID never happened and reality hit. This year really matters, maintaining our GPA so we can attain our goals. Spending hours trying to find some major clarity, only to feel more lost than before. Get a job so we could pay for gas in our cars. It's dark, it's scary, but there's a glimmer of light at the end of the tunnel, and the ride starts to actually be fun. Sports games, a parade, and homecoming, our first ever Powder Puff game and prom that we can actually attend. As this tunnel becomes brighter and brighter, we begin to see the end is much closer than we could have ever imagined. And before we know it, we are at the top of the last hill of our high school coaster. We start off with senior sunrise, and then we're watching our football team win championship, and we're celebrating our last Christmas at home, and then it's prom, and we're dancing the night away, and the coaster keeps getting faster and faster. This is the steepest climb yet. Senioritis is setting in, and we're just trying to enjoy every minute. Mr. Roth's countdown won't stop, and we're now at the end, the peak of it all. The roller coaster slows down, and we are itching for our seatbelts to come loose so we can get out, be free, see what other rides are out there waiting for us. The automated message comes on the ride and says, "We made it." Please join me in welcoming our valedictorian, Abby Heidhart.
Dear fellow graduates, esteemed faculty and staff, and family and friends, it is an honor to stand before you as the valedictorian of this graduating class. As we look back on the past few years, I think we can all agree that our journey has been anything but easy. We have faced numerous challenges and obstacles along the way, from something as large as the pandemic to smaller worries about passing our tests or managing schedules. But we have persevered and overcome all of them. Each of us has a unique story to tell, and it is these stories that have brought us together as a school and a community. Today we celebrate not only our academic achievements, but also the friendships we have made, the memories we have created, and the lessons we have learned. Specifically, I would like to thank my friends, Melani Poyer, Autumn Boley, Ray Tautimez, Isabella Slowick, Rebecca Fletcher, and Emily McDowell. It is because of you all that I have had such an amazing time at Eastmark. We have all grown so much together, and we have supported each other through the highs and lows of this experience, and I'm so thankful for each and every one of you. As we move forward into the next chapter of our lives, we will undoubtedly face new challenges and uncertainties, but let us not forget the lessons we have learned here. Let us carry with us the perseverance, resilience, and determination that have brought us this far. I, for one, know that I would not have been here without a few very special people. To my family, I thank you for your unwavering support and encouragement. You've been my rock, my guiding light, and my inspiration. To my teachers and swim coaches, I thank you for your dedication and commitment to my education and athletics. You have challenged me, inspired me, and believed in me every step of the way. And to my fellow graduates, I congratulate you on this momentous achievement. As we go our separate ways, let us not forget the bonds we have formed here. Let us continue to support and uplift each other, and let us always strive for excellence in all we do. Class of 2023, I am proud to be standing among you today. We are the future, and I have no doubt that we will make a positive impact on the world. Congratulations, and thank you. Fly high, Firebirds. Next, we welcome our combined band and orchestra with the musical number Highland Cathedral. Following their performance, we will hear from Dr. Swaniger, who will present the graduates, followed by the Governing Board Vice President Samantha Davis, who will confirm the graduates on behalf of the Governing Board.
Dear graduates, parents, faculty, and distinguished guests, it is an honor to stand before you today as we celebrate the achievements of Eastmark High School's graduating class of 2023. Today marks a special milestone, as this is the first graduating class to begin as freshmen and attend all 4 years at Eastmark High School. The journey has not been one of ease, but your resilience, determination, and hard work have brought you to this point of achievement and celebration. I commend each and every one of you today. As we reflect on these past 4 years, now is a moment of recognition. Recognition of the many achievements from this group of graduates. Although our achievements could never fully define any of us, they are a testament to the fine qualities each of you have displayed throughout your years at Eastmark High School. These qualities not only ensured your success as a secondary student, but also hold the key to your success for many years to come. I am happy and proud to report that 139 of you, 139 of our graduating students are attending college or university. Two are enlisted in the armed forces. 14 students are attending trade schools. And 5 students are employed directly with their CTE certifications. That is definitely something to celebrate. Additionally, the class of 2023 has 4 National Merit Scholars. And this next celebration here, I think, is absolutely phenomenal. I had to do some fact-checking on this just to make sure it's true. It is true that together, this class, these students that sit before us, have been offered over $7 million in scholarship offers. Incredible. Furthermore, our performing arts students of choir and band and orchestra have received awards of superior in state festivals and competitions. And for our student athletes, these Firebirds brought home a state title in football this year. Two regional championships, one in football, one in softball. A perfect 18-0 record in softball. 18-0 in the regular season. And for our girls football inaugural season, regular season, another perfect season of 11-0. This year, Eastmark had individual state qualifiers in 6 sports, and we had 12 student athletes signing with a college or university to play at the next level. These accomplishments are a testament to the strength and dedication of these students. I am proud to be your principal. But as we celebrate these accomplishments, we must remember that our potential as humans extends far beyond the boundaries of academic, artistic, and athletic success. It is about living in the world of human potential, where we strive to reach our fullest in all aspects of our lives. We must recognize that every single one of us has the ability to achieve greatness and make a deep and powerful impact on the world around us. As Nelson Mandela once said, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. Education not only helps us to acquire knowledge and skill, but it also empowers us to make informed decisions, solve problems, and contribute to society. Education is the key to unlocking our full potential. Now, growth may be a lifelong journey that begins in the classroom, but it continues far beyond the walls of our schools. Yes, classroom performance is not the only thing that defines us. Our potential is also shaped by our values, beliefs, and mindsets. We must relentlessly pursue the best versions of ourselves, where challenges are embraced. Failures, and they will come. Failures are learned from. And the persistence, your persistence, proves stronger than the obstacles before you. We must have empathy, where we seek to understand and appreciate the perspective of others. We must have integrity, where we uphold our values and the principles, even when it is most difficult to do so. And we must have a sense of purpose, where we use our talents and abilities to make positive impacts on those around us. I stand before you here today, confident that the fine graduates of our class of 2023 have all of these qualities to overcome any obstacle that may stand in their way and lead this community, this world, to a better place. In the words of Paulo Coelho, when you want something, all the universe conspires in helping you to achieve it. This quote reminds us that our potential is not limited by our circumstances or the challenges that we face. It is up to us to believe in ourselves and to take action toward achieving our goals. We must be willing to step outside of our comfort zones, take risks, think adventurously, act boldly, and embrace our human potential. Only then can we reach the fullest versions of ourselves and maximize the positive impact on our world. As we look towards the future, I urge you to embrace your potential and pursue your dreams with passion and with purpose. Whether you choose to continue your education, enlist in the armed forces, pursue a trade, or start your own business, know that you have the potential to be nothing short of a world changer. You have the power to create that change, to inspire others, to make a difference. Each and every one of you, you are a firebird forever and always. Vice President Davis, members of our governing board, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for that graduation from Eastmark High School for the school year of 22-23. A total of 185 graduates, I hereby certify that they have satisfactorily completed all the requirements set forth by the Arizona Department of Education. Vice President Davis, may I request you to confirm their graduation. Thank you.
Good evening, Firebirds. I'm honored to have this opportunity to speak to you all tonight. When I was a senior graduating from high school, I had no idea who the governing board members were or what purpose they served in my district. But as a current member of your school board, I want you to know that we care about students. We care about you and your future. We want each one of you to be successful in whatever you plan to do next. I believe that whatever the future has in store for you, or whatever your next steps and plans are, they will be exactly as you want them to be. You are in charge of your future. You will have the exact outcome that you put effort into. You are where you want to be. And if you are not, then you have the power to take steps in making that change to be where you want to be. We don't always know what life will throw at us, but we get to decide how we will react and how much work we will put into achieving our goals. I heard a quote by Babe Ruth once that has stuck with me through the years, and that is to never let the fear of striking out keep you from playing the game. If you are so worried about the outcome being unsuccessful that you never give it a try, then you will never know what you are truly capable of accomplishing. I recently read a checklist for young adults that I believe could be very helpful if applied to your everyday life. First, you will not be everyone's cup of tea, and that is okay. Complaining is a waste of time. Stop complaining and put effort into changing your circumstance. Focus on what is good in your life. Third, kindness is the best answer. Always choose to be kind. Fourth, you do not need to figure it all out right now. The answers are not always right in front of you. Give it some time. Fifth, oftentimes you will pass through failure on your way to success. Learn from those failures and then relish in your successes. And finally, you should forge your own path even if you have to walk it alone. Be a leader. Do what you know is right and others will follow. So what's next? That's up to you. Make a plan, set a goal, and do all that you can to get there. Congratulations to every one of you on this incredible achievement. You have worked hard, overcome obstacles, and grown into amazing individuals. You have bright futures ahead, and I have no doubt that you will make us all proud. By the authority vested in me as the representative of the Queen Creek Unified School District Governing Board, and having been presented and certified by the Eastmark High School principal that you have completed the basic requirements prescribed by the Arizona Department of Education, I now confirm you high school graduates of the school year 2022-2023. Congratulations and go Firebirds. Okay. And now for the moment you all came here for, at this time, I would like to welcome Mrs. Shelley Swisher and Miss Allie Nelson to the stage to announce our graduates.
Abigail Heijert.
Clara Childs.
Natalie Giso.
Luke Crowther.
Chloe Ankrum.
Mackenzie Atkinson.
Aubrey LaHaye.
Candelario Archiga.
Rebecca Allen.
Daniel Armijo.
Felipe Arechnigo Morales.
Javon Ash.
Sanaya Arnold.
Nicholas Bagdalamenti.
Farouz Ayubov.
Asher Ballou.
Carson Bear.
Simon Kanesh.
Max Barrington.
Alaya Barrios.
Ethan Bayard.
Sarah Best.
Spencer Bitten.
Sean Blair.
Tyler Blair.
Kale Blunt.
Autumn Boley.
Mallory Branson.
Jacob Bridges.
Carly Brown.
Caleb Burge.
Caden Burris.
Alejandro Campos.
Aiden Cascante.
Alex Check.
Connor Child.
Jamie Coleman.
Remy Clement.
Logan Cook.
Kylon Conroy. Yes.
Jenna Daly.
I appreciate it.
Jake Daly.
Lillian Darby.
Joey Dankenbring.
Dante Debs.
Christian Davila.
Mackenzie DeWeese.
Jackson Desito.
Tate Doramy. Okay.
Jacob Dixon Atkinson.
Haley Dunlavy.
Caden Dunham.
Joshua Kai Emke.
Gavin Egan.
Soren Ingebretson.
Spencer Elzinga.
Ryan Eubank.
Micah Esquer.
Aaliyah Fajardo.
Taya Udis.
Skylar Fatola.
Summer Lee Fannis. The birthday girl.
Matthew Fernandez.
Adeline Felix Leon.
Omar Figueroa.
Rocco Ferrara.
Rebecca Fletcher.
Lucas Fish.
Luke Frank.
Austin Francois.
Riley Gardner.
Giselle Garcia.
Caesar Gasper.
Steele Gaskin.
Kay Gill.
Lillian Faye Gibson.
Zoe Greenlaw.
Tyler Golding.
Cody Hill.
Kate Hadley.
Ryland Hannah.
Gracie Halter.
Brady Hawkins.
Shane Harrison.
Chloe Haas.
Delaney Hawkins.
Alexis Herney.
Mia Harris.
Michael Holzner.
Aiden Holsinger.
Fernando Jimenez Mercado.
Isaiah Jackson.
Phoebe Jones.
Austin Johnston.
Cody Cornegie.
Haley Kaiser.
Jariah Cries.
Zoe Corpin.
Layla Lasola.
Tyler Kusajewski.
Natalie Limbo.
Ian Levold.
Brooke Leesonby.
Brittany Lisby.
Jacob Richard Kenneth Lucero.
Rowan Littleton.
Logan Marble.
Deshaun Mack.
Yeah!
Jonathan Martinez Gutierrez.
Let's go, Johnny!
Gennaro Martinez Olivares Campos Jr.
Emily McDowell.
Caden McCarty.
Matthew Melendez.
Taylor McNally.
Anna Sophia Arabella Mendoza.
Denzel Mendoza.
Kayshawn Miller.
Janina Messinas.
Malia Monhink.
Mac Molander.
Richmond Morse.
Cameron Moore.
Brian Murphy.
Wyatt Molino.
Evelyn Wynn.
Jenna Nelson.
Carlos Noriego.
Boris Scott Njante.
Maximiliano Orozco Rhodes.
Danielle Uquasica Oduro.
Alyssa Passy.
Easton Owen.
Kennedy Pankus.
Alessandro Pedrosa.
Kevin Pham.
Taylor Peters.
Dax Podani.
Chloe Pirtle.
Milani Hoyer.
Arush Pusapati.
Sophie Prim.
Tori T. Presley.
Preston Purpura.
Braden Prosser.
Diego Rodriguez.
Jennifer Rankin.
Sierra Schoenbeck.
Aurora Salas.
Winter Simmons.
Kyle Schultz.
Isabella Slowick.
Jaden Sirizati.
Kai Spear.
Noah Smith.
Mary Stanley.
Ashton Stanley.
Christina Steven.
Brittany Stapleton.
Vic Stone.
Grace Stevenson.
Mia Tatimez.
Brianne Zabo. Mason Tangi.
Bryce Thomas.
Natasha Tolay.
Sophia Nicole Tuma.
Jacob Tramp.
Isabel Trinidad.
Justin Vega.
Tyler Vickers.
Victor Villalobos.
Quan Vu.
Sadie Wade, join the U.S. Navy.
Tessa Warren.
Samuel Wells.
Darian Welsh.
Diego Welsh.
Alexis Willis.
Mason Williams.
Elise Winter.
Gavin Wilson.
Mason Zaddy.
Thomas Worley.
So I just got to thank our graduates. It's the senior prank that she just keeps on giving. We arrived the other day, and these rubber duckies have been haunting our entire school for the past past week. So thanks a lot, seniors. I will cherish these always. All right. One more huge round of applause for our graduates. Next, we will hear our Eastmark High School choir sing our alma mater, Fly Me Home, followed by a word from our student council president, Aubrey LaHaye, for the turning of the tassels.
Thank you, choir. That was beautiful. Our whole lives, we've been told that time flies. To an old me, the thought of someday not being exactly where I am with the exact same people in my life truly shook me to my core. Some may say that this represents a fear of change, but I simply say that it is falling in love with every moment of your life ever so deeply. Because if there's one thing I've learned through these past 4 years, it is that living every moment to its fullest potential is all that matters. Who knows how many of us would have turned out if one single event in our high school experience was different. Each and every single one of us are birds of the same flock, yes, but we are also our own beautifully and uniquely crafted souls. The little moments that occurred in these past 4 years and the people included in them are exactly what made us so. We have changed, transformed, failed, learned, failed again and again, and definitely will at least one more time. We've loved, we've cried, we've fought, we've laughed, but most importantly, we've grown. The beautiful thing about growing is that it is not bound by the limitations of the passage of time. Our whole lives, we've been told that time flies, but I would encourage you to not let it. Living your life on a countdown of seconds and days is not truly living at all. Breathe in every moment, hold on to it, and then breathe it out ready to soak up another one. Grow as you go, treasuring every high and every low in the process. Whether you have grown to be a completely different person from the one from the summer of 2019, or if you are exactly the same, know that the person that is sitting in that cap and gown today is beautiful, capable, strong, and is officially a high school graduate in that moment we move our tassels from the right to the left. The turning of the tassel is a tradition used to signify a person's transition from candidate to graduate, a symbol of success. Graduates, please join me now as we move our tassels from the right to the left. Our whole lives, we've been told that time flies. If that's the case, then it's a good thing we're firebirds. So in the words of a very good friend of mine, firebirds, let's fly.
Told me that someday these will be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
I was thinking about the band, I was thinking about the fans. We were underground, loaded merch in that 12 passenger van. In a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up. Still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I've become. Couldn't wait to get older. Couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me